God for one thing, as far as fruitfulness is concerned. Is it career fruitfulness? Lord, change my job. I need to see results. Is it your business? Lord, let this business take a new turn. Lift up your voice and pray from the depth of your heart. Lord, give me a change in my job, in my career, in my business. Give me a change. Let there be a change. Let the delay be broken. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ, let the delay be broken. Father, you say you will increase us. You will multiply us 1,000 times more. Let this service spark off a new dimension of fruitfulness in every area of my life. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. If you are saying amen, say better amen. After this service, God will increase you beyond where you are. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. The testimony you have long waited for, it will be put in your hand in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Make that amen louder. Let the Redeemer of the Lord say so. Congratulations. Please get seated. God bless you. Still in our teaching series, empowered by the Spirit to fulfill my glorious destiny. And in this covenant day of fruitfulness, we are going to take in three series. This first service will be focusing on the power of dedication. The power of dedication. Second service will be focusing on the power to bring forth. And third service, war against barrenness and their sponsors. The power of dedication. God is a big God and is noted for only doing big things. God does not do small things, he does big things. He introduced himself to Abraham as the Almighty. And as our father Bishop Abiyah says it, he said, there are mighty men, but there is only one Almighty. Everything in this kingdom produces after their kind. There is an order. There is a sequence. There is a pattern. So you are not just living life to chance. When you have an understanding of your roots, then you are bound to take delivery of your fruits. Because your roots determine your fruits. So knowing your roots is the first thing that is needed to be in place to deliver you out of hopelessness. Knowing your roots. Your destiny is not determined by what is happening to you, but what has been written concerning you. Has anything been written concerning you? So in knowing what God has said concerning you is a pointer to where your life, where your destiny is heading to. Thank God for efforts. Every one of us must of necessity make efforts as part of our input and ensuring to see that what God has said comes to pass in our life. But the moment a prophetic word is declared concerning you, the future is already defined. As you are seated here now, your future is defined. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. So the moment you receive the prophetic word, tell your brain, relax. Your brain can be going haywire, giving you all manner of confusion. Will this thing work? Why is it not working? If it is supposed to work, why has it not come? But I want to let you know that God's word cannot fail. He said, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the word that have gone out of my mouth. I'd like you to understand that fruitfulness is not even your choice. It's not your choice. You are sentenced to it. You are stamped with it. God said, be fruitful. Everything God said, be, no devil can unbe. No witch can unbe. Even if the Lord even send 1,000 monitoring spirits into church to know whether you are pregnant, who saith it? And it cometh to pass when the Lord commanded it not. My counsel shall stand, and I will do all of my good pleasure. Be. Everything God said be, they became. The Lord of hosts has proposed, and who shall disannul? His hand is stretched out. Should I tell you something? The problem is you. The problem is not the person that is angry or that is monitoring. The problem is you. Scripture says he watcheth over his word. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void. It shall accomplish and prosper in the thing wheresoever I send it. You must be what? I say you must be. Fruits have source. Am I correct? fruit, they have what? The source of fruit is what? Seed. One of the persons that made Ghana what it is today was someone that went to Veranda Pole. How many of us have heard the word Veranda Pole? Good. It's just like someone traveling abroad. So his abroad was Veranda Pole. So the only thing he brought back from Veranda Pole was cocoa seed. And when he came back, he was mocked. Others, they travel, they bring better thing. You na bag of smelling seed, now you gonna carry come for us. So he didn't argue with them. He told them that what I brought is what my children will eat. So if I'm not around, they will be eating from it. So he brought cocoa seed and they started planting. After about 10, 15 years, that was what Ghana dwelt on and upturned the economy of Ghana until Ghana became the first leading nation of the supply of cocoa. Just follow me, we are entering, we are talking about the power of dedication. Every fruit has what? Seed. The fruit of the mouth is what? Words. Hidden in the tongue is the power of life and death. And them that love it shall eat the fruit. So what is the fruit? Words. Now I want you to understand, God's seed is in you. He that is born of the flesh is flesh. And he that is born of the spirit is what? And Paul said, Christ in you. The hope of what? Tell your neighbor there is hope for you. So in you is the seed of God. Even God told Satan that the seed of a woman shall bruise thy head. Now that seed that we are talking about is the seed of the Spirit of God. Let us make man in our image after our likeness. Let us make man in our image after our what? Likeness. And let them have what? Dominion. But their dominion is tied to their fruitfulness. So the seed is already in you. But one thing that will guarantee the seed to produce is what we call dedication. Tell your neighbor dedication. John chapter 12. Verse 21. The time came there for to Philip, which was of Bethsaida of Galilee, and desired him, saying, Sir, we will see Jesus. Philip cometh and telleth Andrew, and again Andrew and Philip tell Jesus. And Jesus answered them, saying, The hour is come that the Son of Man should be what? Glorified. Verse 24. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abided alone. But if it dies, it brings forth much more. It brings forth much fruit. So there is much fruit in you. Shall I say something to you? You are over fruitful. I say you are over fruitful. But your fruit will require dedication to experience manifestation. If you are not dedicated in this kingdom, you are not permitted to flourish. So what we call barrenness is just a product of ignorance. There is nothing mysterious about unfruitfulness. Why? Because it's not in God. God gave to me and you what he has. Am I saying the truth? That's why I want you to hear this. Satan does not have any new brand of attack. There's no new attack. Jesus has collapsed his backbone since. So if you are trying to make it look as if it's very special, I want to let you know it's not special. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Dedication. Jesus needed to plant his own seed to reap. If you are not dedicated, you are delaying your fruitfulness. Dedication has power to unlock every good thing that God has put inside of you. And like we are meant to understand, everything good that must enter into our hand will require power for them to be delivered. And it takes dedication to trigger power. It takes dedication to trigger power. And as far as fruitfulness is concerned, hear me, you need dedication, growing dedication to experience consistent fruitfulness. Ordinary people do things at their convenience, but dedicated people, they are addicted to what they are doing. Why? Because there is a cost that goes with it. There is a cost. So dedication is your seed. You are dedicating your seed. Your seed is you. Your seed is you. You sow your time, you sow your energy, you sow your intellect, everything. It must yield results. Scripture says, he that goeth for bearing precious seed to sow shall doubtless return with his sheaves with him. You can't be dedicated until you have understood your roots. My root is in Christ. So my fruit must reflect my roots. Oh, the psalmist said, they that be planted in the courts of our God, they shall flourish. Where are you planted? Because dedication requires a planting. No, it is in Psalm 92. Psalm 92, I think verse 14. Is it verse 14? No. Go down again. Go up to 13. Good. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Verse 14 now. They shall still bring forth fruit. If you are not planted, you can't bring forth fruit in old age. Please put the scripture back. They shall be fat and flourishing. Verse 15 now. To show that the Lord is upright. He is my rock. And there is no unrighteousness with him. Meaning, faithful is he that calleth thee, who also will do it. He abideth faithful. He cannot deny himself. If you are dedicated, it's just a question of time. Are you what I'm saying now? Dedication has a way of rebranding you, repackaging you, repositioning you, bringing you out in a more glorious color to show that the Lord is upright. Meaning, you can't be dedicated and end up being wasted. You can't be dedicated and end up useless. God forbid. I don't know if I've said it before. I was mocked too. They mocked me full scale. You say you want to be pastor? Oh, they are brainwashed you. I remember when I graduated from the university. I was looking for a job. Was writing all manner of CV, doing all manner of things. One day I went with my father to a particular place to see somebody. We got there at 9 o'clock. We came back almost 7:30. I told my father, don't go again. Don't carry me there again. Leave this thing. I will never go to that place again. If you say it's from my village, please don't mention my name if people will go for your meeting. Very soon, I'll be richer than him. I told my father. I said, write it down. I said, very soon I will be richer than him. Today, the man is as broke as coconut. What he's busy doing now is selling off all the properties he has gathered. We are just starting. About 2 years back, he sent a message that he wanted to see me. I said, if he wants to see me, he should come to my house. No. Not me, go to his house. For what? Levels have changed. I'm much more now carry oil. How about? Me come to your house to come and eat what? Which kind of food will I never eat for this life? How about? If he wants to come, his driver should bring him. Simple. Please, stay dedicated. Your life is glorious, oh. I say your life is glorious. Anything you have not seen, I want to let you know it's not behind you, it's in front of you. It's not in your back, it's in your front. Where's the future? Where's the future? As scripture says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has he entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for them that love him. Hear me? Stay planted in this house and you will flourish. I've not seen a dedicated man that ended up useless. Everyone that stayed dedicated to God, they ended up being distinguished. of distinction in career, in business, in family. Don't worry, second service, third service, I will talk about the fruit of the womb. Just relax yourself. But you know, the reason why things are not working for some people, one leg in, one leg out. You are not serious with God. You are, hear me? Scripture said, choose this day whom you shall serve. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Until your mind is made up to be dedicated, you cannot serve God with your whole heart. Some people have advised themselves, take this church thing easy, take this church thing easy. I don't want any, that man is just go to church, finish service. I don't want anybody to greet me. I just enter my car and leave. You will need this church. You also need this God. Your battle never starts. When your battle starts, your Christianity will be serious. It is better you have roots now, so that when the storm comes, God can defend you. People that don't have roots, that is why they are visiting prayer houses, looking for quick prophecy. Emergency prophet. Where you will not be buying anointing oil for 50,000. This one, a strong one. If you use this one, it will go. They are everywhere. Somebody came one day, not here, brought oil that should pray for him. So he now put, is it 2,000 Abi? 3,000? That this is for the oil. I say, you and your oil get out now. He say, Pastor, no verse. All the places where they go now, so they do. I said, this place is different. Go with your money plus the oil. You know, in some places, if you want to see pastor, you fill form. Form is 1,000. If your case is special, it's 5,000. So, you have not seen anything. So, if they fill 20 form, it can amount to 100,000. That is business, man. But not in this place. Not in this place. Hear me? The closer you draw to God, the more things get well for you. I'm going to summarize with this scripture. 2 Chronicles chapter 15. Read it from verse 1. And the Spirit of God came upon Azariah, the son of Oded. And he went out to meet Asa and said unto him, Hear me, Asa, and all Judah and Benjamin, the Lord is with you while you are with him. And if you seek him, he will be found of you. But if you forsake him, he will also forsake you. Now for a long season, Israel had been without the true God, and without a teaching priest, and without the law. To be pastorless is to be fatherless. I will give you a pastor after my own heart that will feed you with knowledge and understanding to this end that you might be what? Established. They were without a teaching priest and without the law. Continue, please. But when they, in their trouble, did turn unto the God of Israel and sought him, he was found of them. And in those times, there was no peace to him that went out, nor to him that came in, but great vexation were upon all the inhabitants of the land. Pause there. Now hear me. God said, you went out and labored and brought it in, and I blew it out. Why? Because of my house you have ignored. Many think it's the exertion of energy that is producing the result. No, the God factor. The God factor. If God is not with you, you will suffer like Jackie. Verse 6. And nations were destroyed of nation, and city of city. For God did vex them with what? No, not adversity. All adversity. Look at it. All adversity. Which means they were experiencing hardship in every direction. Things were hard. Things were tight. In fact, even the people that were favoring them switched off their number. Anytime they see your number, they pause the number. The next verse. Be strong therefore, and let not your heart be weak. For your work shall be what? The next verse. And when Asa heard these words, and the prophecy of Oded the prophet, he took courage and put away the abominable idols out of all the land of Judah and Benjamin, and out of the city which he had taken from Mount Ephraim, and renewed the altar of the Lord that was before the porch of the Lord. The next verse now. And he gathered all Judah and Benjamin, and strangers with them out of Ephraim and Manasseh, and out of Simeon, for they fell to him out of Israel in abundance when they saw that the Lord his God was with him. Verse 10 now. So they gathered themselves together at Jerusalem in the third month, in the 15th year of the reign of Asa. Verse 11. And they offered unto the Lord the same time of the spoil which they had brought, 700 oxen and 7,000 sheep. And they entered into a covenant to seek the Lord God of their father with all their heart and with all their soul, that whosoever will not seek the Lord God of Israel shall be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman. And they swore unto the Lord with a loud voice, and with shouting, and with trumpet, and with cornet. Verse 15 now. And all Judah rejoiced at the oath, for they had sworn with all their heart, and sought him with their whole desire, and he was found of them. And the Lord gave them rest round about. Dedication goes with an oath. If you be dedicated, you will swear it. You provoke it with an oath of commitment. Serving God is not optional. You either serve God full time or you serve Satan full time. I've not seen anyone that served God with the whole of his heart and ended up as a non-entity. You may start as a non-entity, but you will end up as a sub-entity. If you are saying amen, say that amen. Amen. They entered into a covenant to serve God, and the siege of adversity was broken. Dedication is the key. Dedication is the cure to your delay. You shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless your bread and your water, and he shall take sickness away from the midst of thee. So when serving God now becomes your choice, say, Lord, make sure nothing else work if I change from serving you. Dedication. So productivity is tied to dedication. If a corn of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it abideth alone. But if it dies, it brings forth much fruit. Hear me? If things must work for you, there must be a place where you are planted. And you know, where you are planted determines the fruit that comes from you. So people may be mocking you now, but their mockery has come to an end. I said it has come to an end. A dedicated man is a mysterious man. I'm summarizing with this now. We are going to rise up to pray. A dedicated man is a mysterious man. What makes him mysterious? Who has planted him before? Raise your hand. If you have planted him, are you afraid? Now when you plant him, what did you plant? Good. You planted seed, Abby. Now, has it occurred to you anytime that, I'm sorry, some of you must have tried this and you have seen your foolishness before. You planted the yam because you are seeing the leaf. You now went under and started scratching. Did you see anything? That is the mystery. But after a while, the real yam now begin to appear. Now, when you are dedicated, it will look as if nothing is working. But in the realm of the spirit, something is changing. Something is changing. I remember when I was in primary school, we had one onions, the leaves, the thing that started growing like this. So I went and planted it. So the thing, the leaf now grew plenty. So I said, that the way this thing is growing, it's like the thing has grown bigger. So I now carried knife. I started digging from one side. After digging for a while now, I now discovered I didn't see anything again. The only thing I was now seeing is white root. I was angry that day. Why was I angry? The leaves that were shooting out gave me the impression that a big onions have come out, not knowing that there was nothing there. So I told my father, I said, close it. I closed it. After some months, he said, don't go and open it again, no. Just wait. 2 months, 3 months, 4 months before we know what's happening. Real onions came out. Now, dedication is mystery. Why? Because that is your platform for exchange. You are exchanging your shame for your glory. What they call barrenness is fading away and your fruits are emerging. Oh, somebody is not catching it. Paul said, though the outward man perisheth, yea, the spirit man is being renewed day by day. And he puts it this way. He said, it may look as if we are perishing now, but an exceeding weight of glory. An exceeding weight of glory. So when you are dedicated, you are heading for glory. You are heading for glory. And the glory that will come out is the fruits, is the results, is the profits, is the increase. You hear me? There is no mystery anywhere. If you are dedicated, you must bring fruits. No wonder Jesus concluded in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things that the Gentiles do seek after shall be added unto you. Rise unto your feet. You can't be dedicated in this kingdom and miss it. I have one of our sisters in Port Harcourt. We're very close right from orientation camp. He's a member of this commission. The husband's sister was so devilish to the point that she went and removed her own womb and use it to do juju for her and to say that she will never have a child. But as I'm talking with you now, she's pregnant for triplets. She's closer to deliver. She's very close now to deliver. I tell her, stay connected in God. God is the doer. And hear me? Scripture said, the fruit of the womb is his reward. Whose reward? Not man's potency. You can be overpotent. But the fruit of the womb is what? So relax yourself. I had one of our members in Refit. She's a medical doctor. They've done IVF tire. But after a service like this, it just came. I said, God says, I should tell you, don't go for any IVF. It was the week, and I never knew. Before you know what's happening, that same month, she took him. The husband was confused because the man took an American doctor. Wait, are you sure? Are you sure? You know, when God do it, that's when Satan will now begin to manipulate you with doubt. But God punished devil. Pregnancy started to grow. Started to grow until 9 months. So, on the day of the delivery, all the man's colleague, senior consultant, said, you mean this thing is real? It was like film. They were watching free film. They brought out the baby. The man could not hold it. He started crying. He said, so I've been wasting my money all this while. Without me, you can do nothing. As this oil come upon you now, you are going to pray, Lord, I have labored. I have sweated. Surprise me. Show me what makes you almighty. Prove your awesomeness in my life. We had one of our members, his name is Mr. Davu. Him and his wife, they've been believing God for 28 years. They had their first baby last year. After 28 years. The man has seen what we call mockery. You know, there's mockery and there's what mockery. No, I didn't say monkey. They mocked them left, right, and center. As the pregnancy took place and it was time for her to deliver, money come out by force. The man had to take the wife to Lagos. All the mockers, he left them alone and went to Lagos, delivered the baby. We did the naming on phone. So after, yes, sir. And later they now came back. I want to say to someone here, I don't know you, I don't know your face, but I'm seeing you. They have mocked you to scorn. But if truly I am sent by Oyedepo with proofs, whoever mocked you will be among those who celebrate you. There's another one here. It has even gotten to the point that your husband's junior brother has fought your husband because you have not given birth. But I stand to tell you, as a son of Oyedepo, your mockers will bow for you. Right down to this date, if truly I'm sent to Lafia, your shame is wiped away. Your disgrace is taken away. You have cried in the secrets, but God is announcing your laughter in the open. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Fruitfulness is not natural, it is spiritual. And scripture says, it shall come to pass in that day that the body shall be taken away from thy shoulder and his yoke from off thy neck. I make bold to say to someone, as this oil come upon you today, I pronounce you fruitful. I pronounce you fruitful. I declare you fruitful. Before what is oil come upon you, you're going to lift up your voice in the next 2 minutes. Father, no man can help me the way you can help me. Holy Spirit, you are the help of God for me. Let your help manifest in my life. Turn every unproductivity into productivity. Every barrenness into fruitfulness. Whatever represents shame, stagnation, Lord, overturn it for me. Nakushito esozena. Inkayute esusialita. Shekle tusa likre dusano. Turn everything. Mockery. Shame. Reproach. Into fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. La roche kote pebele tu zaza. Nandi halo shekute tenish. In sodia ekoteno. Jesusi eklope predi. Lekoteri jezoni labara. Hold on, don't move yet. Just hold on, don't move yet. Lerodo shikote pezi sosia. In Jesus' name we pray. Just hold on. If you are here, you are not born again. Just carry your bag and your Bible and come out. I'll be the one to anoint you. Just come out. Just come out. Defy that voice you are hearing. Come out right now. Put your hands together for Jesus. If you are coming, come out. Put your hands together for Jesus. Your days of mockery, they are over. Your days of mockery, they are over. Hold on, hold on. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. Say after me, Lord Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. Wash me with your precious blood. I reject sin. I reject Satan. Come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. If you pray that prayer with me, just come right now. Put your hands together for Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. If you pray the prayer, come. God bless you. You don't need to be ashamed. If you are coming, come quickly. Put your hands together for Jesus. Help me, help me, help me. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Come. Come, come.
I overflow. I want to run all night.
I wanna
run. I wanna run. I wanna run.
Hallelujah. There are nothing less than 9 more persons still standing. But I want to tell you, come out. This is your best moment. I'm not going to beg you. 9, I know. If you are coming, come out. Before I finish anointing them, by the count of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, Shakataya. Jesus, no one come unto you except the Father draws. La Rosha Tali Henon Rebishata. Change their story. Change their story. Whatever has held you to this point, the yoke is broken. If you are saying amen, say better amen. It is done. In Jesus' name. Put your hands together for Jesus. Follow this man. Everybody take the oil right now. Move fast. Move fast now. Move.